Hello, everybody. Welcome back to WWTF, one of the fastest game show, Mike C.
Now, Fred, why?
All right, y'all, Fred did it. You know what he got right here. This big old device. Heavy device I got in my hand. What is this called, Fred?
It's called the Cheeseburger.
Cheeseburger Pro. Pro. Cheeseburger Pro.
Yeah, right. Man. I went on ahead and got it to see what all the hype was about. This is just a basic review because I don't have a 4K TV. So I can't go into real details about it. I haven't even hooked it up other than turning on and put my account in there and all that other stuff. But as Mike said before the show, it's heavier
than
the original PlayStation.
What do you think about the design? I really care less about the design, honestly. It's really not all that appealing to me. It looked like it's just a PlayStation stacking on top of each other.
Yeah.
And cheeseburger, like you said. That's what it looked like.
There are a few differences in it. If you look at the back, you see that it has a power. The power brick is inside, as always, the PlayStation. But this looks similar to a power supply or power cord for a PC.
Yeah.
Not so much because it doesn't have the third, I guess, the ground in there. Mm-hmm. So it kind of resembles the power cord that goes into the brick.
Yeah.
Of the Xbox One.
That's exactly
what it reminds me of.
Wow.
And then it just has an extra USB port in the back, and that's for your virtual headset. And I was trying to upgrade this to a 4 terabyte hard drive, but the 4 terabyte hard drive that I got, it was just too big.
Mm-hmm.
And the hard drive for that is just back here.
So it just hooks back there.
Yeah.
So it's a good location for the hard drive to be instead of. But I liked it in PlayStation 4.
Yeah.
All you had to do was just, it was really easy to snap it, but unscrew it, take it out. You could change the hard drive in PlayStation in like 3 minutes or so.
Right.
If that, you know, and it was real easy. You just download the file online, it's very accessible, and just load it up, man. So it's really easy as far as updating your hard drive compared to what it was back then. But, man.
I mean, it's easy with this, too. The only difficult part that I had was trying to figure out how to take that flap off so I can get to the screw to slide the hard drive up. And on the front, well, the bottom of it, you have a couple of PlayStation symbols and squares and triangles and stuff like that. And that just rises it a little bit off the table. And let's turn to the front real quick. These are physical buttons. Oh, well, the front of the unit.
So the physical button under here.
You can hear that. The physical button. The power on button and the eject button. So no more of your cat with his tail or your dog with his tail
just brushing
on it, and then your PlayStation is on for a while.
Yeah.
So that's about it, man. I can't really give a full review because I don't have a 4K TV, so I can't give you the differences on this one and the original PlayStation 4.
There's not.
Then, Mike, you had asked me a question earlier.
And I forgot what that question was.
About sitting it on its side.
Oh, yeah. Can it sit on the side like the PlayStation?
Yeah, it can.
But
I think that is a dangerous thing to do. Because even with the stand, if you sit this stuff on the side, if you notice, it has these intake vents.
Mm.
But if you sit it on the side, especially if you don't get a stand, you're blocking this. And that's even for the regular PlayStation.
Wow.
So it's trying to suck air from two tiny holes right here. Other than sucking air from the other sides, you know, and then the intakes, you got to get that canned air, and you got to blow it out,
and all the other stuff,
and that's why most people consoles die because they don't clean that air out.
Speaking of which, I got to buy some for mine.
Me
too. Making a lot of noise, like the train coming or whatever.
Yeah.
I need to get me some air can.
And they say it runs hot, and I don't have any concrete evidence that it does because I don't even have the thing hooked up yet.
I'm about to take it home and try it out, so I'll let you guys know.
And
on that note,
we gotta remember where we was at. Hey, hey, Eric. It was hey man, I'm shooting the show.
you suck, Fred.
hey, I'm gonna call you right back after we finish shooting this episode, Eric. people are talking about it overheating, and it's not pairing up to the TV through due to the 4K signal and all that other stuff. When I hooked it up, I didn't have any type of problem with it yet. Again, I'm not dealing with 4K TV. I'm just dealing with a standard 1080p TV. So, you know, as I get a 4K TV, I'll just update the episode. But for right now, you know, I'll show you how to install the hard drive, at least to get that up and running. Because the reason why I don't have this thing up and running is because I don't want to lose PT. That's on my original
PS4. Yeah, you definitely will lose that because I lost it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. I deleted it, and I'm like, oh, man, I should get it back. And then by the time I thought about downloading, it said, no longer available.
Yeah.
All right.
Wow.
This will be having a game that comes out like it, but we'll see. All right, so I guess that's it about the PlayStation 4. Like always, you guys can hit us up at thegamershow@gmail.com. That's the Gamer Show with an A. Don't forget to head on over there to the store. And don't forget to hit us up in V-Time.
And please remember to like, subscribe, and follow all our social media networks, join our SteamWorks community, and our website community where we get some cool stuff. We'll see you next time on WWTF.
With the facts.
The Gamer Show.
See you next time. Keep on watching. Thanks for tuning in.